Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. The last of the paper mills, historic paper mills in Coos County, is slated to close October 13th. And we're going to talk about that in a minute because of its importance to the North Country. First, let's go to these graphics to show you what's happening. Fraser Papers of Gorham are in bankruptcy. They agreed in May to sell to a merchant bank, and merchant bank put together a group of investors, but one investor suddenly withdrew. The sale fell short. 240 jobs are now at risk. The last of the historic paper mills in Coos County, once a haven for mills in Berlin and Gorham. They produce tons of uncoated papers and towel products. Now, here is the mill. This is the picture of it up in Gorham, of the inside of the mill. This is the mill that fueled, along with many others, fueled the economy and social fabric of the Androscoggin Valley for more than a century. But the industry has suffered a long decline. There was a time when thousands of people from all over the world came to work in these mills, but since 2001, they have been in decline, and the last mill is set to close. With me to talk about this is Jeff Pollack, CEO and directing manager of Merchant Bank right here in Manchester. Welcome.
Thank you, Fred.
You had the mill in your grasp. You had investors pulled together, and you thought you had a sale in the making. What happened?
Well, we came to agreement with Fraser Papers at the end of May to purchase the assets of the mill. And our intention was to keep the mill running and actually move it forward into the very profitable and growing tissue segment.
Right.
We had to accomplish a lot of things in a very short period of time, which we did. Mm. One of those was to bring in a large co-investor. We were able to bring in an investor from California. And during most of the summer, we spent time with them up at the mill with their consultants, arranging the investment and continuing to do what's called due diligence, the research.
Right.
At the end of August, they suddenly withdrew, and we were left with a month under the contract that we had with Fraser to arrange the purchase to try to put something together.
Now, before I ask you where this could go next, let me ask you, how important is this mill to that area? Gorham, we're talking about.
Oh, it's critical. It's one of the largest employers in the North Country. These are jobs that are not easily exchangeable into other kinds of skills.
Right.
Most of the people there have been working there their whole careers,
yep.
20, 30 years in many cases.
Probably the second or third generation to work in the mills.
We spoke to many people that was the case.
Yep. What is the potential here for this mill still to be opened again? I know that the state and the Commissioner of Resources and Economic Development, George Bald, is working on this. What kind of potential do you think there is for this mill still to be operating?
Well, George, Commissioner Bald has worked very hard with us and subsequent to our involvement. I do know that Fraser Papers is interested in selling the mill as an ongoing operation still.
Right.
They are trying to do that. They have also announced that they are going to shut down operations indefinitely as of October 13.
Right.
So I think there's always a chance, but unfortunately it's a very short window.
Before we end, very quickly, from where you sit, Merchant Bank, which invests in niche companies that have promise, and I know that's what you do all over the state and other parts of New England, do you see this economic recovery coming back from where you sit in this state?
I see it. Fortunately, New Hampshire was hit less hard than a lot of other places, and therefore I think we'll probably experience a recovery sooner, but it's a long, slow, gradual recovery.
Yeah. Jeff Pollack, who is CEO and Managing Director of Merchant Bank right here in Manchester. Thank you.
Thank you, Fred.
You can see this interview again at WMUR.com. Just click on Project Economy.